A mother won't risk lying down to feed her calf. Lowering her body to the ground would make her an easy target. This delicately balanced beast spends as little time as possible bending to drink or lying down to sleep. In fact, they can get by on as little as 10 minutes sleep a day. This long and heavy neck seems to cause more problems than it solves. Drinking, breathing, pumping blood to the head, simply standing up, it's all difficult. Does the benefit of reaching a few more leaves really outweigh all the costs? Or could there be something else going on? Is there another, less obvious advantage to having a long neck? We're in the final stages of our giraffe dissection. With the neck bones exposed, pathologist Alan Williams can begin his detective work hunting for clues that may reveal the cause of this animal's mysterious death.
Once all the muscles have been taken off, you end up with seeing the vertebrae underneath. And the most obvious thing, I mean, a lot of people think there must be just loads and loads and loads of bones in the neck of a giraffe. There aren't.
Yeah, just the same number that we have. There are two up here, one, two, three, four, five, six, and there's number seven.
Okay, so same number of bones as in us.
It's just that each one of these has tremendously elongated during evolution and growth.
And there's still a little bit more work to go on there. But Alan, in terms of, obviously we know that this animal died from an acute unexplained paralysis. Any clues here from having a look at the neck in detail?
Yes, we have. We've discovered a number of things in our dissection. And if I start around the head, if we look at this muscle here, instead of looking like this nice normal colour, it's become much darker, this bleeding in the muscle, suggesting that there's been some impact onto the lower part of the head, almost as if the head has hit the floor.
OK. So your next step to take the neck apart even further or not?
Yes, I think what we'll do shortly is just take one of these vertebrae out so we can actually see inside.
Okay, Richard, are you going to be able to do that for us? I mean, what it begs the question of is obviously being tall brings certain very distinct disadvantages, and one of them may be if you stumble, you fall. The taller that you are, the harder you fall. It's serious.
Even though falls can be fatal, giraffes are far from fragile. When British couple Kathy and Steve Auckland filmed these gentle-looking giants on safari in Tanzania, the last thing they expected to see was this.
It's like a snuff.
No, I haven't seen this on the telly either.
In head-to-head battles like these, males with the largest necks dominate. They'll win access to the most females and are likely to pass their big neck genes to the next generation. This could well be a factor in the evolution of the neck. But there's another theory that involves the beautiful skin patterns of giraffes across Africa. They all share a hidden secret.
These patches are for camouflage, first and foremost. But underneath a patch is a really sophisticated little blood system. Around each patch runs quite a big blood vessel. And that blood vessel gives off smaller branches into the middle of the patch. And what a giraffe is able to do is to send blood, when it needs to lose heat, through these little branches into the middle of the patch. And then the heat is given off through that patch to the environment.
When viewed through a thermal camera, the remarkable properties of the patches become clear. Each one acts as a thermal window, switching on to release body heat.
You can see the patterns here. Our thermal imaging camera was showing up how these were glowing brightly. There's a lot of heat coming from those.
And the longer the neck, the more surface area available for these heat-losing patches.
If you want to keep yourself cool in somewhere like Africa, having a long, thin body is a good way of doing it. It increases your surface area dramatically. It's much, much better than being, say, fat and squat. By lengthening themselves out, they're able to cool down. And this means they don't have to hide in the shade all day. Instead, they can keep feeding anytime they want.
The evolution of a body shape that stays cool under the African sun could well be an important reason for the giraffe's extraordinary neck.
While looking for clues to the cause of death, Alan discovered bruising around the lower jaw of our giraffe. Now he wants to go deeper and examine the spinal cord.
So if we just take a knife here and see if we can... And if we just look here, if we have areas that are just slightly discoloured here and here. It's very difficult to see with the naked eye, but they are not the colour they should be, which is suggesting to me there's bleeding into the spinal cord itself, damaging the nerves that spread messages to control limbs. So this is all supporting the idea that this giraffe has lost its footing, and the degree of impact as its neck and head hit the floor has caused bleeding and urines and the nerves to stop working properly.
The ultimate cause of our giraffe's death was a simple fall. It highlights just how costly this elongated body and neck can be. So, will there be another chapter in the remarkable evolutionary story of the giraffe?
Back of everyone's mind, you're saying this is a creature that's living right on the edge. It won't take much for the disadvantages to outweigh the advantages. And then the species will crash, just like all species do when they've come to the end of a suitable environment. And that's what I think that this animal is doing right now. It's right on the edge of what an animal can do.
We get used to the idea that evolution produces almost perfect design, the illusion of design. It looks exactly as an engineer might have done it. But what's very revealing are those imperfections which we sometimes find, imperfections which no designer would ever have perpetrated, but which are exactly what you'd expect if living creatures were the legacy of history.
What's its where inside a giraffe? Test your memory of animal anatomy by playing our four animal autopsy games at channel4.com/insidenaturesgiants. On Wednesday at 10 on More 4, a profile of post-war technological breakthroughs in engineering Britain's superweapons. Next tonight, Kenneth, David and Tom hatch an evil plan, but B wants nothing to do with it in Big Brother.